In this video, we discuss the seven saviors sent to the people of the planet Earth over the past 6,000 years, before the return of Koshi Yabawehu, or as some say, Yahweh. There have been seven saviors, messiahs, or mahdis, over the past 6,000 years. Revelation 10:7. But in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished, and he hath declared to his servants, the prophets. The first savior was named Rama. Rama was born in India and is sometimes referred to as Vishnu. He was a black man sent to the people living in India during their time of strife. The second savior was Zarathustra. The Persians have started a religion based on his legend known as Zoroastrianism. His name has been recorded as Zoro or Zoroaster. The third savior came to the people of South America and delivered what would be eventually known as the Mayan calendar. Many blacks migrated to Africa after the savior revealed the truth of the origins of the light races. They left behind what's known as the Olmec skulls. This third savior was known as Quetzal. The fourth savior, Musa. When corruption was brought to Egypt, God raised Moses, or Musa. Moses was brought with a dual purpose. His purpose was to give comfort to the suffering people of Egypt under Pharaoh and to raise the Caucasians into civilization out of the hills and cave sides of Europe. For more info on this, you can check out our video, 6,000 Years and 4,000 Years Ago, What Really Happened. The fifth savior was Jesus. His teachings would eventually become the gospel used for Christianity. The sixth savior was Muhammad. His teachings would eventually become traditional Islam used by the Orthodox Muslim. The seventh savior is Master Farad Muhammad. He was born February 26, 1877, according to the Christian calendar. John 5:26-27. For as the Father has life in himself, so has he given to the Son to have life in himself. He has given him authority to judge because he is the Son of Man. The Son of Man would come to usher in the new world and judge this world. If this occurred 2,000 years ago, then we would not still be dealing with Satan's world today. Because we can clearly see that we live in a greedy, war-hungry, and power-driven world to this day. This illustrates that a man would come to judge a man, not a spirit, but a man. According to Elijah Muhammad, the base of spirit is form. Spirit can only act through form. The formless God or the spirit God is just a plain lie. This lie has kept us from connecting with our divine or higher self, as it causes us to separate the two. The spirit of God lies in you. The spirit must work through a form. This teaching given to us by Master Farad Muhammad through his messenger Elijah Muhammad fulfills the scripture of Revelation 10:7, that the mystery of God should be finished. As is said, God came in the person of Master Farad Muhammad. This statement is very clear on who Master Farad Muhammad is. He is the one who would reveal the truth of the mystery of God in the last days. He came to the United States and took a man with a third grade education and taught him for only 3 years and 4 months. And that man would go on to completely change the conscience of all black people on the planet Earth, fulfilling the scripture of raising the mentally dead. Think this over. He raised a man who had a speech impediment and gave him enough information to raise a nation. Master Farad Muhammad also gave the measurements of our solar system and taught of 7 inhabited planets within our solar system. He introduced the information that would help create modern genetics. Master Farad Muhammad is that one, the savior with the wisdom of the Most High in the last days. His father was one of the 24 elders. His mother fulfilled the scripture of Revelation 12:1. And there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. Those 12 stars represent the 12 major scientists that approved of this divine birth. Master Farhat Muhammad fulfills the scripture God did by sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh to be a sin offering, and so he condemns sin in the flesh. The word likeness reveals that Master Farhat Muhammad was not actually a being of sinful flesh, but would resemble those who were. Master Farhat Muhammad is the final Mahdi to come before the raising of the 144,000 and the return of Yahweh, or Koshi Yah Bahuehu. Peace.